बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर सेफ एंड फाइन इन दिस पेंडेमिक बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ अल्लाह अज़्ज़ा वजल। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर लेसन नंबर 1 ऑफ सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज एंड आवर टॉपिक इज़ नाउंस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, this is your book and the name of the book is The Grammar Tree, second edition, The Grammar Tree. We review our topic nouns. What is noun? A noun is a word that names a person, place, things, animals or any idea. What is a noun, students? The definition of a noun is very simple. A noun is a person, place, thing, animal or an idea. Examples: person like boy, girl, doctor, Tom, etc. Places like city, France, street, home, etc. Things: computer, apple, money, glass, etc. An idea: love, emotion, beauty, etc. These are all the examples of noun. Dear students, nouns can be classified in these ways. It means that there are two main kinds of noun. That is common noun and proper noun. What is common noun? General names common to entire groups, just like doctor, mountain, war, love, etc. Now proper noun, what does it mean? Proper noun means a specific name. Okay, common nouns mean general names, proper noun means specific names, one of a kind thing. For example, Dr. Phil, Rocky Mountains, Civil War, etc., etc. So these are the two main kinds of nouns, that is the common noun and proper noun. Common nouns: a common noun names any person, place, things or idea. Common nouns are not capitalized unless they come at the beginning of a sentence. For example, teacher, baseball, city. These all are common nouns. Proper nouns: a proper noun names a particular person, place, things or idea. Proper nouns are always capitalized. Remember students, proper nouns are always capitalized. The examples of proper nouns are Statue of Liberty, Abraham Lincoln and Dubak Loa. Are these the examples of proper noun? Dear students, points to be noted or remember from common noun and proper nouns are: number one, a common noun names any person, place, animal or thing or idea. Common nouns are not capitalized unless they come at the beginning of a sentence. A proper noun: a proper noun names a particular person, place, animal or thing or idea. Proper nouns are always capitalized. Collective noun. Now dear students, what is collective nouns? Collective nouns means one word that names a group of people, animals or thing. It means that collective nouns are a special kind of common and proper nouns. A common or proper noun, that is the name of a collection or group of similar things or persons, is known as collective noun. For example, an army of soldiers, a team of ducks and a bunch of keys. These all are the examples of collective nouns. Examples of collective nouns: a dynasty of kings, a tribe of natives, a draft of lecturers, a pack of thieves, a flock of tourists, a team of workers, a choir of singers, a giggle of girls, a class of students, a circle of friends, a colony of penguins, a pride of lions, a catch of fish, a flock of sheep, and a zoo of wild animals are all the examples of collective nouns. Open your books, Grammar Tree. Open page number 2. There is an exercise. Exercise A. Today we will do exercise A. What we have to do in this exercise? We have to pick out the proper and common nouns from the following sentences and state which of the common nouns are collective. In this exercise, we will pick out the proper nouns and common nouns and also state which of the common nouns are collective. We also have to mention which of the common nouns are collective. Okay, students? Now start. Number 1. A herd of cows was grazing in the field. In this sentence, herd, cows, and field are common nouns. Okay, you have to underline the common nouns and proper nouns with the pencil. And the word herd along with common noun, it's also a collective noun. Okay, it's also a collective noun. A herd of cows. There are lots of cows here. So this is a collective noun also. So we have to underline the collective noun with the blue color and common noun and proper noun with the pencil. So in this sentence, the word herd is a collective noun and also common noun. Cows is common noun and field is also common noun. Next, there was a pile of books on the table. In this sentence, pile means there are lots of books. So it's the word pile is collective noun. So we will underline it with the blue color. So pile is a collective noun and it's also a common noun. And the books and table, these are both common noun. Okay, so you will underline it with the pencil, books and table with the pencil, and you have to mention above the word, although the word is common noun or proper noun. Okay, so there was a pile of books on the table. Pile is a collective noun. Books and table are common noun. Number 3. All living creatures need food to survive. Creatures and food. You have to underline the word creatures and food, and these are common noun. These are common noun. Okay. Number 4. The magician turned a bunch of keys into a pigeon. The word magician is a common noun. Pigeon is also a common noun. Okay. Now the word bunch means there are lots of keys. So it's a collective noun along with common noun. Okay. The word bunch is collective noun along with common noun. And the words magician and pigeon are common noun. In the 5th sentence, the Mazar-e-Qaid is a special place for Pakistanis. In this sentence, the word Mazar-e-Qaid and the word Pakistanis are both proper noun. As you remember, I told you earlier in this video that proper noun are always begins with the capital letters. So Mazar-e-Qaid and Pakistanis are proper noun. Okay, dear students, now rest of the exercise from number 6 till number 15. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. All these sentences, you have to do it by yourself in your book very neatly. Dear students, one more thing. It's not necessary that common noun, proper noun and collective noun all are present in each sentence. It's not necessary, okay? Hope you all understand this exercise very well and will do it in your book very neatly.